My name is Robert Weeks. I'm a mixed martial artist and personal trainer. Today I'm at Main Event Sports Club, and today I'm going to be teaching you about bodybuilding for the average guy. Guys, bodybuilding, isn't it exciting? Isn't it tough? Do we not sweat? Do we not cry? Do we not be in pain, blood and sweat and tears? But how good does it feel at the end of the day to go home knowing all the work you just put into yourself, knowing that in a few days, a few weeks, a few months, everything's going to change? Well, welcome to the life of the average bodybuilder. We're not all Arnold. We're not all superstars, and we're not all with 22-inch arms. A lot of us, average arm size is anywhere between 13 inches and 15 inches. That's an average man. If you have 22-inch arms, you're very rare. The average bodybuilder needs to take that in consideration. I know you see a lot of magazine covers. I know you see a lot of models, actors, and talents out there in the world that seem to have a very unearthly-like ability to gain muscle and mass. Do not always be confused by this, and do not always be allured by the fact that you're seeing somebody big and you want to be like them. You need to take in consideration what you have, and the fact of the matter is you're human and you have a lot of things to offer. Now in bodybuilding, the average person wants to take in consideration what it's going to take for you to sustain a bodybuilder's diet. That's more important than the workout itself. A bodybuilder's diet is very important because you're going to want to make sure you keep up a proper amount of calories and you keep up a proper amount of protein. Protein is a synthesis in your body that your body breaks down amino acids in order to acquire mass. Mass is then distributed appropriately throughout your body. And if you want more mass to acquire in one more area than, let's say, the other, you must put a lot more attention into this area than, let's say, another area. A lot of people want big arms. So you see a lot of people in the gym doing a lot of bicep curls, doing a lot of pull-ups and push-ups. They're trying to really isolate these bicep muscles. They're really trying to get that peak in their definition. But the problem is they don't realize that working out major muscles actually grow out your smaller muscles as well. So just isolating one small muscle could actually be doing more damage to you than good. So what? You have nice looking arms. Your legs look like toothpicks. You need a nice set of shoulders to make those arms look really nice, and you need a nice neck to hold it all together. You need a nice core to hold it all, to really make it all a nice package, and your legs obviously have to keep your weight up there the whole time. The average bodybuilder is not going to want to get too overwhelmed by what he sees on TV, but just more what he feels in his heart. You feel like you can do enough weight and you feel comfortable you can go more? Keep pushing it out. Make sure nobody can tell you what you can and can't do. The average bodybuilder is the reason why Arnold Schwarzenegger is here today. He was the average bodybuilder before he became professional. And that's bodybuilding for the average guy. See you next time.